Well, hello everybody. Look, my hat's all crooked. It's been smashed in the back of the Jeep. And you can see we got some orange on because we are in our fourth section of the Mark Twain National Forest. This would be the Devil's Backbone Wilderness. Been meaning to get down here for some time now. You probably noticed a gap in my videos because I just kind of lost interest there for a while. I've got footage stored away, I just haven't put it together. And we got out here kind of late. As you can see, the sun's already pretty low. We got about 4 hours or so before it gets dark. We started at the McGar Ridge Trailhead, which is in Ozark County, Missouri, just outside of Dora, Missouri, which I guess is where she hangs out when she's not exploring. Plan to spend 2 days out here. This is our first time being on the Ozark Trail. We'll be on it today for a short distance, part of tomorrow, and then we'll be off the Ozark Trail and on wilderness trails that take us up the Devil's Backbone, which is a tall, narrow ridge. Elevation change out here is anywhere from 600 feet to around 1,020. I imagine the Ozark Trail, you won't see a whole lot of elevation change, at least today anyway. But from what I understand, the Devil's Backbone Trail is a little strenuous. So we'll find that out tomorrow. But for now, we're just gonna keep hiking on. Well, we found a geographical marker. Those are always kind of cool to see. Wanted to let you know, we chose, today is Wednesday, November 16th. And I chose these 2 days to come out here because it's the last 2 days that we're going to see 70 degree temperatures. After that, we got a cold front moving in Friday. Today's Wednesday. It's gonna be cold and wet. So we decided to come out, enjoy these last few days of 70 degree temperature, and explore our fourth section of the Mark Twain. Guys, this section of the trail, and we've just gone a little over a mile, appears to be an old road, as wide as it is. And even with all the leaves, it's easy to tell where the trail is, which is a good thing, because for the Ozark Trail, it's not blazed at all, or at least it hasn't been so far. A ways back, I've seen where the upper wilderness loop, I think, comes out. I'll show you that on the map later. We shouldn't be but about a half a mile or so from a spur trail that I want to take to go check something out if we have time. Ooh. So let's see if we can find that spur trail. Well, I think I might have found the spur trail. It's a little bit further, if this is it, a little bit further than what I thought it would be on the map. Because we went second. 1.7 miles from the trailhead before I seen anything that headed back towards the right. It looked like a trail. Oh. I'm using my tripod. It's getting hung up. So,
tell you what, guys, Sheba
has a lot easier time of seeing these leaf covered trails than I do. I'm sure she can smell other people and horses and animals and stuff have been using it. It's kind of hard to see. She doesn't have a problem with it. Almost to the bottom. If we go back up this tonight, it's a hell of a climb coming down. It's gonna wear me out going back up. About fell twice, huh, Sheba's? Or since I'm carrying this heavy tripod, I didn't bring my walking stick with me. There's the river down there, if you can see it yet or not. Oh, tell you what, these leaves cover up the rocks that will break your darn ankle. All right, let's see what we can find down here. Guys, I think we found the spring. Thank goodness, because I didn't want to go much further. We got to turn around and go back up that dang ridge. I'm going to drop the pack right here, unhook the camera, and I'll be right back. And I'll show you when we get down there. You can see where the water's bubbling up out of the ground. Let me see if I can remember what this spring was called. If it even says on the map, Blue Spring. That's Blue Spring. And from what I read, it puts out about 8,000 gallons or 8 million gallons of water a day. She was taking advantage of that spring water. Look at this, guys. That's pretty deep right there. I'd guess 6 to 8 feet. Water's just coming right out of that hole. And going right into the North Fork River. Isn't that freaking awesome? That water is just crystal clear. This spring is just cool as heck. And I mean that literally, that water is cold. Well, we found the spring, and now we gotta head back up that big ridge we came down, back to the trail, and then another mile or so, and we should be at the river, someplace where we can actually set up camp. So I'll see you in a little bit. Well, I guess sun fading me. Now that I can breathe, I'll tell you that spur trail to the spring starts out nice and flat and then just drops off down this ridge forever, it seems like. And I knew it was gonna be, there's a butt kicker coming back out of there. I don't know how much elevation it was. I'd say, you know, not a lot, but it's pretty dang steep. Very few switchbacks. We are about to the end of this ridge, I believe. And somewhere up here should be another spur trail that leads to some campgrounds right by the river, which will probably be another big downhill. I could camp anywhere up here off the trail. I don't need water. Got plenty, but I think it'd be cool to spend the night by the river. And then I'll decide tomorrow what are the trails we're gonna take. Because I haven't worked since September 17th, and unless I was hiking, I've been pretty lazy. And that hill, it did, it kicked my butt. All right, let's find this other trail. It's gotta be close. Well, we finally made it to where the trail splits to go down to the river. And we've been slowly going downhill for the last quarter mile or so, but it hadn't been too steep. But as you can see, the Ozark Trail keeps going in that direction, and this is supposed to lead us to some campsites down by the river. And until we're getting closer, because the foliage and stuff has changed from what it was up on top of that ridge, we got a little bit further to go downhill and we should be able to set up camp. Well, guys, I say we made it. There ain't a soul around either. Got us a fire pit in case I feel like it. There's the river. Very cool. That water is really clean. As you can tell, I've already lost the sun here. There, it's hitting that hill ridge over there. Just the tops of some of those trees. There ought to be an easy way to get down to the river somewhere. I bet Sheba finds it. But I think we're gonna call this camp for the night. It's all sand. Good thing I have a tent that's freestanding. Although the town, the radio station for the town, 2 hours, where'd I go? Here I am. 2 hours east of here, west of here, had a wind advisory for tonight, 26 to something miles per hour. Another 40 minutes west of there, my hometown, had the same thing. I don't know here. if we're gonna get a lot of wind or not. But it sure is pretty. Ah, let's get camp set up. What's up, guys? We had a good hike in today. Hold on a second, let me get the map. All right, I'm back. I'll show you the trip we made today anyway, and what we're thinking about doing tomorrow. See, let's get things right here. Here's a map of this section of the Mark Twain, and we parked right here. There's another trailhead over here, I'm guessing, for this section, so you don't have to cross the road. But if you're through hiking, you'll have to cross the road. But we came down, came over. And then this is where we split off and went to the spring. As you can see, the blue spring. This right here is very steep. That was a burger coming back up. But we came back up there, got back on the Ozark Trail, took it down to this point where we split off again and came down by the North Fork River. Now what I have to figure out, because what I was wanting to do tomorrow is come back, catch this section of the Ozark Trail, come down to here, and then take this Devil's Backbone Trail, which follows a ridge to the upper loop, and then take the upper loop back to the Ozark Trail, and then back to the car. I can either do that or just take the upper loop here. I haven't made up my mind yet. The guy I talked to in the parking lot said this is a real burger. The first part of it, from K on, doesn't look too bad at all. It's pretty flat. The elevation is not all at once. Yeah, I don't think it looks too bad. We'll figure that out in the morning. Sheba's over there checking stuff out. I got some firewood cut up. Already got the tent all set up, ready to go. We're just sitting here and enjoying the view, which it is awesome. There she is, making sure we're all safe. It's really quiet right here. I mean, down that direction, I can hear the water. Right here, it's just really peaceful and pretty. Sheba's had her dinner, and I'm about ready to cook mine. And oh, I guess I could show you. I'll have to get it out here. Hold on a second. I brought a different pot this time. It's from, what was the name of it? Snow Peak? Yeah, there, I'll show you. Snow Peak titanium, has a silicone cup and a silicone lid, so I'll be checking that out lighter weight. I went with a smaller fuel canister. My pack, I don't have any way of weighing it, but I could tell in comparison to another trip I went on recently where it was like 36 pounds, I could tell it was considerably lighter this time. Let me get you set back up here. 1 second. There we are, close enough. Trying to get this out. Apparently, here's the lid for it. It's just a silicone lid, silicone cup, titanium pot, and it doesn't weigh nothing. I bet it heats up pretty quick too, because we're gonna have some noodles and chicken, because that's about all I got left in Mountain House Meals is noodles and chicken. I've ate everything else. I think I got one lasagna left. That's about it. So we're gonna get some dinner cooked up. We'll see how long that takes. It's 4:54 right now. Half serving. Woo. Hope you're hungry, Sheba. They got so much in here I can't get it closed back up.
Said it was 4:54.
Two minutes and it's already bubbling on the bottom. If that titanium heats up quicker, that's going to save my fuel too. That's why I quit using these little canisters, because they use so much, they don't hold as much fuel. They don't last as long. Then you end up with a bunch of them that are half full and you're afraid to bring them. I know Smelling Roses said he uses those for his lunches every day. Takes a couple of them. So if one runs out, he's got an extra.
What'd you get back? I ain't got nothing for you. I ain't got nothing for you. Yeah.
And you're sitting here with me watching water blow. That's better than watching the grass grow. I don't have it turned up all the way. I didn't want it to shoot much over the corner of the pot. Get my handles hot. In 3 minutes. Oh yeah, 3 minutes and we got a rolling boil.
Oh crap, the lid fell in.
Now, are the handles hot?
No, not really.
Not too bad. Bad enough.
Woo.
Do that.
They didn't feel too hot at first till I actually grabbed a hold and held on.
Yeah, remember my other pot? It has a grabber and then it has an insulated koozie that you can put it in. Then you can handle it
think that actually looks pretty good. I hate quitting too much here. You put too much in, you end up with like lasagna soup and stuff.
Since Dan's Depot is no more, that's the last of those fire starters I got. They're like a wet fire, only bigger.
I know you guys can barely see me. The only light we got going is the fire. As you can see, the sun's just about gone. We're only a couple of days out from supermoon, so I don't think it's going to get too dark. I was going to test the flashlight out tonight, but I can still see all the way across the creek, the river. So I don't know how much of a test that would be. Got the fire stoked up, as you can see. Whoa, there we are. Focus. Just pretty much put everything on there, because when it burns down, I'm going to bed. This was a much needed trip, let me tell you. We hadn't been out since, well, I've done a couple of day hikes, but I haven't done an overnighter since I got back from Virginia, which was, October? I went in October. I think we left on the 8th or 9th, something like that. I spent 3 days up there with smelling roses. I still got that video to make. If I haven't done it already, by the time I put this one out, I don't know what sequence I'm going to put them out in. I've got videos from, oh goodness, September, last week of September, from meeting Bob 808 Knight, Bill in the Hills, Billy Denny, and Kenneth Cram down in Arkansas, where the first trip we'd done an overnighter and went and found an old cemetery that nobody had been to in years. And we spent the night just down from the cemetery where we think an old school might have been at one time. So we spent the night there, and then the third day we hiked in to it was an old mine, and basically they'd mined this whole dang mountain. Bob had spotted one spot on his GPS, and we went and checked out this old mine. That was really cool, so I still got that video to make. Well, I'll get caught up eventually. For now, we're going to sit here till the fire goes down, and then we're going to bed. Good morning, everybody. Just waking up. Got some coffee. Thought I'd bring you down and show you the river. It got pretty chilly last night. And when we got got down here, I thought, well, heck, maybe we'll just set the tent up down here, right by the water. And trust me, had it been warmer, we would have. But it's colder down here. The sun's just coming up. And this is a beautiful area. Absolutely beautiful. I think I've decided we're not going to push it. I can always come back. But like I mentioned yesterday, I haven't been doing a lot of hiking in the last month and a half. And I ain't 20 years old anymore. So I think we're just gonna take it easy, take the Ozark Trail back to the Jeep. We'll come down here and do some more exploring another time. Ain't nothing in the hiker rule book says I had to push myself. So I'm not going to. You like my do-rag? I didn't want to get shot. There's people deer hunting out here. And I don't want to be their trophy for the day. So I think we're just going to do some cliff bars and stuff for breakfast. Get everything packed up. And just slowly make our way back out here. One last look at this beautiful river. Well, guys, it's 10 o'clock. I decided that since we're not going to be doing a lot of miles today, we just hung out here, let Sheba play in the water. But we got camp all cleaned up. It's a fire pit. I even got rid of some trash that was here when we got here. Left it better than we found it, and now we're getting back on the trail. This was an awesome place to spend the night. Got a little chilly. Another reason why it took so long getting ready this morning is there was a lot of moisture build up on the rain fly. So I had it draped over the tripod trying to dry it out. It's still a little wet, but I'll set it up when I get home. After it quits raining, it's supposed to rain tomorrow, I think. I don't know. They don't know. We're gonna make our way back out of here. If I see anything significant, I'll be sure and show you. Well, we made it out of that valley by the river, and I'm glad I made the decision to just backtrack and not try to do some of the other trails out here, because I'm pretty tired. That trip yesterday back from the spring wore me out. I gotta quit being lazy and get back into shape. Sheba's leading the way. Like I said yesterday, she can see the trail better than I can. So she stops. Go, baby. guys, we're real close to the end of the trail. Let's see. Didn't really see any wildlife, except for an eagle. We heard turkeys, and last night we heard the coyotes. Man, they were just getting after it. That seems to become a common occurrence anymore. That's a pretty tree. And seeing a lot of this. That's beautiful. This trip is what I needed. Get me back out in the woods. Sheba's been going nuts. This trail's easy to follow, even though it's covered with leaves. And not blazed at all. Maybe they didn't blaze it because it's so easy to follow. That could be. But I'll see you guys when we get back to the car. Well, the Jeep looks intact. Let me see if we got a sign out. Nope. Just sign in. I guess they don't care if you made it out. And the Jeep looks fine once again. That's always a big plus. Always worry about it. All right, let's get this gear off. All right, guys, we made it back to the car. Where did my phone go? Here it is. It wasn't a long trip, but it was a good one. That spring was really cool. 8 million gallons of water a day, crystal clear. Total trip is 7.6 miles. Highest elevation was 935 feet. But total ascent was 1,552.9. So we climbed a little bit in 7.5 miles. Average speed, 1.6 miles an hour. That was a good trip. Well needed. And I want to thank you for joining me, if you lasted till now. And remember, get out and live life.